It is planed here, but once it gets to Japan, it'll be hand planed. A representative from the West Coast told us that it takes them up to 2 years to build a home.
Is that so?
Yeah.
And now this is all cut on the reservation.
This is all our hemlock on the reservation.
Stepping back in time again to 1910, this is the Moore and Stoltzer Lumber Company of Portage, Wisconsin. The mill was located about 9 miles northwest of Rosholt on Holt Creek. Lumber from all the mills had to be piled with air spaces between the boards for drying. Most homes before the turn of the 20th century were heated with wood, and dump carts, such as this one at Eau Claire, were used to haul the slab wood to local residents. Early sawmill owners like George Stevens at Big Bull Falls and Daniel Whitney at Nakusa had no railroad cars to ship their lumber to market, but they could float their lumber to market on the great river highways of Wisconsin. This 1847 painting, titled Raftsmen Playing Cards, by George Caleb Bingham, is probably the earliest illustration of lumber rafting in America. The painting depicts rafting on the Missouri River. Here is an engraving which appeared in Harper's Magazine in 1855, no doubt the earliest visual evidence of a lumber raft on the Mississippi River. It is not a big raft, and the men on the oars are able to guide it fairly well. The A-frame kitchen is a shanty on the deck, and the cook has a fire on a bed of sand to cook for the crew. A close-up picture of three lumber rafts on the Red Cedar River for Knapp, Stout & Company of Menominee. The first stage in assembling a lumber raft was to make a crib 12 feet wide and 16 feet long. Three cribs hitched together made a rapids piece. The sticks seen along the edges were called grub stakes and were used to bind the lumber together. Long oars appear at the stern, and the pile of bundles are shingles, which are carried as a deck load. From Dunnsville, the rafts went into the Chippewa, through Durand, and down to the Mississippi. These were called Chippewa rafts, made up of three rapids pieces joined together. Royal Henson of Merrill, Wisconsin, has built an authentic model on a scale of 1 inch to the foot of a lumber raft as it was used 150 years ago on the Wisconsin River. Here he holds the basic unit called a crib, which measured 12 feet by 16 feet. Tiers of lumber or planks were laid down on a framework, each tier crossways to the one below it for at least 15 tiers. The lumber was held together by the pegs seen at the corners and on the sides called grub stakes. Holes were augured through the outside planks, and these grub stakes were squeezed through these holes.
They had these planks completed. They would take what was called a grub stake and put through these holes, or the planks were set down rather on top of the grub stakes. This is a general idea of what a grub stake was. It was about 4.5 feet long. This is not quite straight, but they had to be pretty much straight. And they always had a large growth root on the bottom of the stake so that the planks sliding down over the stake could go no further than this. They'd go right to the bottom, and there they laid. Get one crib made. First crib made, they would slide it off the shore, float it in the water, and tie it up to the bank. Then they make another crib. When that one was done, they'd slide that into the river, and they'd hook it up to the first crib with nothing but slab wood coupling pieces. They're just piece, about 5 foot piece of slab wood with a couple holes drilled in it. Those were put down on top of the grub stakes, one hooked to the other, like that. It was pliable. As they floated down the river in the water, they could move. But it worked. It held them together. The leading crib in each rapids piece was tilted like this, so the front end would plane like a boat does. It was lifted with the use of these prow poles. It went under the head block and over this block, and it was held up there by these prow poles, which were also held up by the same wedges that they used in making the rest of the cribs. It was held up there just by driving wedges in next to the grub stakes. Then when they went down the river, it would plane over the sandbars a little better and such as that. But it was still very, very difficult to control these big, heavy rafts on the river, and surprisingly, very few were lost.
Three cribs in tandem were called a rapids piece. It was called a rapids piece because this was the most practical length for running a dangerous rapids, such as the ones over the ragged rocks at Mosinee and Wisconsin Rapids. Three rapids pieces tied side by side made a Wisconsin raft. These were not assembled until the fleet reached the slack water below Wisconsin Dells. From here, the Wisconsin rafts were floated down the river below Prairie du Chien and into the Mississippi. Joining several Wisconsin rafts into one was called a Mississippi raft. Mill owners at Marinette, Menominee, Peshtigo, Green Bay, and Manitowoc loaded their lumber directly onto schooners sailing the Great Lakes. Here are two taking on lumber at Sheboygan in 1891. And another schooner taking on a cargo of lumber, this one at a yard in Manitowoc. The destination of most of the sailing ships carrying forest products was Milwaukee and Chicago. Robert Wakely of Upper New York State built this house in 1837-38 to serve as a stopping place for river drivers gigging upstream and for transient lumbermen and traders. It stands a short distance south of the Nacusa Dam. The lumber for the house was probably sawed at Daniel Whitney's up and down sawmill, located about a mile north. The building has been altered by installation of windows, but the basic structure remains unchanged. It is probably the oldest frame building in Wisconsin, west of Green Bay, and is presently a landmark, preserved by the Southwood County Historical Society. The final segment of the Wisconsin Logger series, part 4, will show and demonstrate old tools and techniques of the woods and Wisconsin's finest logging museums.